Hello YouTube, I'm Tom Jakes and I'm here with Chuggy and Matt. Bet you're expecting the community race that we've done today, but unfortunately a lot of shenanigans happened and I got booted, so the footage was not uploadable.
Yeah, shenanigans is
but
for it.
Me, Matt and Chuggy would like to kind of describe what happened within the opening laps.
Yeah, because by the sound, by the sounds of it, we each got a different view of the start, which I think contributed a lot to what then later happened, so...
Well,
who wants to go first?
Seeing as I'm not actually on the game, you guys talk me through what's actually going on.
So what we've done here is we're both in Caterham, so it's relatively similar cars, but these were the grid slots we started in 5th and 6th. And ahead of us, that's right, Matt was right behind me. Mm-hmm. And ahead of me was Mike in the next grid slot. I'm not sure if we can see me here, but
yeah, I can see you.
As I pulled away, Mike's didn't move. He was the stationary box. I wasn't sure what the hell was going on. So what I did was this, basically.
Well,
floored it, and then
we went, then came across. I was kind of here, over at this angle, and kind of as we got closer, started moving out towards the outside. Now, Matt had gone around the outside of Chuggy, so he was on the outside
screen,
of the corner.
Everybody got off the grid cleanly, and Chuggy just pissed off.
And this is what happened between me and Matt. We got to about here, and Matt came across because there was someone pushing him or something. I can't remember. What was it, Matt?
I was taking avoiding action.
Taking avoiding
what I
action.
See is becoming an accident.
Came across, hit me on my left, and I got that close to the wall. Just missing the wall and destroying my vehicle.
Sorry, Tom.
Don't worry. Chuggy?
Right, so I'm not sure if you can look behind me, but my race went wrong from this point. So, I took evading action on Mike because I wasn't sure if he was there or not. The next thing I know, I've made the move. I see Tom behind me, a fueling car, and I see Mike just disappear off the distance. So, there was some lag. So, I was like, okay, well, that's not so bad. There was room. So, I'm carrying on down here quite happily, quite enjoying what was going on. The next thing I know, a Williams is on my left hand side and comes completely across the front of me, like, did not clear me. It pushed me left into what I believe was a Mercedes on the racing line. And we tangled together, and I went directly at this wall, about this angle. Bang. I then, for whatever reason, I think someone else then hit the rear of me, started to barrel roll down the whole length of this straight. I kid you not, barrel roll. And about here, I think I got flipped onto my nose, so I started doing end overs. I think a few other people hit me. I just kept going. Unfortunately, Gran Turismo 5 here, which we're currently in, I should say, lost off the chicane. But I came to rest just on the other side of this wall on the grass, upside down on the top of the chassis. I then get rotated onto the wheels and trundle onto the course. Penalty, multiple illegal overtakes, down into last.
Do you want to know what happened to me?
Yeah.
Came down here, missed my braking, so I was braking frantically. Came to here, Mike's was on my left. We had a little tango down through here. Came through. I think it was a Mercedes that spun it, I can't remember, at this corner, came round, hit his rear tyre, bit of my nose broken. Then, I can't replicate it because I actually just spun round, but got hit from the rear, I don't know if I can reverse up, and ended up here. Got back, I saw you actually dart across the exit of that corner.
What, like, of this corner here?
Yeah, on this skate road, hang on.
Yeah, so when I was on my wheels, it replanted me on my wheels somewhere around here. And I remember looking behind me to make sure I wouldn't rejoin in front of anyone. And I saw a Ferrari and a few other cars backwards, facing the wrong way. So I pretty much took this angle here, slowly watching behind me. Second one over the white line, penalty.
Well, what happened is I saw you just come straight down here, Chuggy. Straight blasting down this road here and coming down.
What, all the way over there?
All the way over here, hang on. When you said you got your penalty,
yep.
Keep following me.
Are you doing the Curva Grande?
Yeah, that's where Tom is at the minute.
You were here, coming off the gravel onto the track. And then that's where you said you had your penalty.
Yeah, I got the penalty back there. What I was doing there was taking avoiding action, because I had no front nose, or front wing, I should say, obviously given the fact that I was flipping. So I got out off the track, just to let people through.
Do you want to know what happened on my view?
Yeah.
First corner.
Do you want to go back to the first corner? No.
Yeah.
Right, I follow everybody off on the first corner. I brake at 150 just to, because I know there's going to be an accident in the first corner, so start braking, brake, brake. Sure enough, Ian, who was on pole, and I think it was Mystic, who was second, or someone, they, like, the three cars that weren't Mike's, basically, came together, and they were going all, there's cars and car parts going all over the place. Tom was nowhere to be seen. Like, Tom just didn't appear. Mike's clips the first apex beautifully, takes a second apex beautifully. I basically follow his line, and then the two of us just fuck off. And we just, like, so right.
You're saying that accelerate. I wasn't on the track?
You were nowhere near me or Mike.
See, I went down the complete inside, just completely locked up. And you were behind me at that point.
Well, anyway, as we said briefly before, we all got different views of the event. I'm expecting everyone who took part in the race would have had something similar. But what I think this proves is lag is not a good thing. And, well, Tom, I think this is where you need to step in. But basically, if it's going to be that laggy in-game, I don't think we can really carry all the races.
We've had a few races where it's been good fun.
Yeah, but it's more rooms.
Yeah, it's the amount of people that there are, and plus their connectivity as well. And with me hosting with Matt connection and then us on Skype as well, just kind of the only way we could get it done is if we had super fiber optic broadband, which we don't. So I hate to say it, but I don't think there'll be any more community races because of it's kind of not possible anymore.
Well, yeah, unless we have like rooms of six or so.
Yeah, but just,
four,
so. Yeah, just trying to organize that as well, who gets to join in. It'll just be completely unfair, so it's probably best to say no more. I would say sorry
but
about
anyway,
that
yeah
anyway I have got a few games for videos to do. I've got Dark Souls, which I've had since its release and I haven't opened it, and I got Final Fantasy, I've got Prototype as well. What else have I got?
Many other anyway.
Body count as well.
Laps, as we discussed what we were hoping to discuss in the race, apparently, when Pete Tom. Right, so this week's had a lot of events. As we're speaking, it's the weekend of the Bahrain Grand Prix. My views on it shouldn't be happening, but it is. And, well, all sorts of crap's happening. So, this is Saturday we're recording this on. And
21st.
Yep. So, quality's happened. Vettel has pulled it. Well done, young Messia Vettel. And the race is going to happen tomorrow. But Bahrain, for me, shouldn't happen for two reasons. First of all, as a circuit, it's not particularly...
Oh, come on, mate. It's a good circuit.
It's a short circuit now, bro. Not the long circuit that was in 10.
I know, but even still, there was only one really decent section. It's the, like, long left, downhill to the tight left.
That was... That's tricky, and it's challenging.
Yeah, it's the only decent corner on the course. So I'm not particularly keen on the course myself. A little bit of oversteer there. Oh, dear. Walker.
You've just done a Hamilton, mate.
Yeah, I just did do Hamilton. So that's one thing. I'm not particularly... What was that gay?
Did do Hamilton.
You I just did A.
You said no, I just
said did do A.
All I heard was did do Hamilton.
Yeah, well.
Selective hearing.
Yep, your hearing is crap as usual anyway.
Or lag.
Oh, yeah, blame the lag when it suits you. Anyway, so I'm not particularly keen on the circuit. Now, obviously, there's a political situation as well, and I believe it is actually in the FIA charter saying that no FIA event should take place where it'll be used for political gain or something to that effect.
Is that actually in the charter?
I believe so. So the very fact that the race is even there is a disgrace because the government and the Bahraini government and others are using it as a political tool to show that the country is fine, quote unquote. And, well, we can see by the footage we've seen of, well, people being shot dead, being shot, firebombing.
One was found dead this morning, weren't they?
Yeah. And what I find most disgusting is this. So on, I believe it was Thursday, the Force India team were on the way back to the hotel after sorting themselves out on the track. They got caught up in an incident, a riot or something. Some firebombs thrown, some tear gas thrown. Bad times all round. What has happened today, well, and what happened on Friday as a result, is that they decided not to take part in all of free practice too. They would send people home early, so they would avoid anything like that. Now, I'm not sure if many people picked up on it, but at least on the feed that I saw from, well, Sky and the BBC's angles, is that Force India were not shown in any of the coverage. Now, I think that is despicable, right? Now, Formula One management, Bernie Eccleston's lot, managed the feed. It's the Bahraini TV equipment which captures it, but it's FOM who decides, you know, the camera angles and everything else, which I use. I think that's just despicable. Bernie trying to get Simone back. I think it's terrible. And I think it says a lot about the sport.
In today's footage I saw, Bernie looks very, very sick. I wouldn't be surprised if in a year or two he has to either, he's either medically forced to step down, or we don't have Bernie Eccleston.
Well, the thing is, Bernie, I think he's going to carry on doing the old Formula 1 management until he dies.
He will keep going to Formula 1 until he croaks.
Yeah.
It's literally going to be the death of him.
But I think it's the wrong situation. The track, personally, for me, isn't worth it.
And there's too much going on in the country to even consider it being safe.
I hope nothing bad happens tomorrow. I really, really do. But I've got a terrible feeling something's going to happen. I hope I'm wrong.
It's like saying, let's have an F1 in Afghanistan. If you say, if you give Bernie Eccleston £1 billion or whatever, he'll probably
he'd
do it.
He'd send his drivers in. Yeah. He'd send the drivers in.
It's all about money.
What should have happened is when, you know, the Bahrainian government first off refused to provide extra security.
Did they? Yeah.
Yep. They refused to provide extra
security.
They
said it's safe enough.
Bernie or the FIA or someone should have turned around and gone, right, we'll spend this much money, like a couple of million. Hire someone like Blackwatch or another private security company to turn up and stand around the track. Anybody without an ID badge gets pissed off. ID badge or a ticket.
Chugga, I couldn't see you in my mirror then.
Yeah.
In my whole right hand mirror, I was looking at, I knew you were there. I was like, I can't see him in my mirror. Does he exist?
Well, hello. But yeah, I personally, I don't like the fact Bahrain
happen.
I hope nothing bad happens.
Well, if they can get out of it tomorrow and get a clean escape, then
what? Do the older thanks for your money. Peg it now.
By the sounds of it, the way things are going, the race won't be renewed. So, and well, I warn you now, Tom. The car's quite tail happy round first Lesbos.
I will say this. I reckon the Bahraini government put so much threw so much money at Bernie to say we could not afford to lose this race for a second year.
Yeah,
because that would have been it. It'd have been 2 years in a row, right? We're not coming back.
Well, there is a legal condition if the race doesn't happen 2 years in a row. That's it. And so, but anyway, yeah, an unfortunate set of events, and it's what we're facing with. I think it's wrong. A lot of people think it's wrong, and the whole situation is just not good for the sport.
It's FUBAR.
I'd hate to be a driver actually trusting the government and FIA to get things sorted and make it safe. I would not like to be in that position.
I would not trust Bernie.
Or would, have you ever trusted him?
I mean, as a driver, I'd lose my faith in Bernie.
Well, as I've said before, Bernie's done a lot for the sport in prior years, but I think these days
it's gone to his head now. Well, it's like they say, power corrupts, and he's got absolute power over the commercial rights for
Formula One.
So it has corrupted him absolutely.
Oh, I'm trying to get in Chuggy's toe, but he's just too fast.
Hell, I'm in top gear. Wait for you to catch up.
Nim 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 nim. I know that's Mike's. Oh, I've maxed out.
Yes, thanks.
So anyway, yeah, the community races, don't get me wrong, I love being in them anyway. Yeah. I think you two can echo that. Matt, Mike certainly can as well. But unfortunate set of circumstances in Bahrain. I don't like it. I think a lot of the people don't like it, but that's the situation we're facing. Mm.
Me and Chuggy having a good scrap here, which we didn't have in the...
Yeah, unfortunately.
I have to say, sorry for sending you almost into the wall, Tom, but on my screen I was having to take evasive action.
Don't worry. I almost hit the wall, and I'll probably show you the footage in a bit after you're done with SWOTOR.
Actually, 1 second. Who won the race? I do think we should give those two
Ian.
Guys a... Yeah,
Ian,
the,
and it was...
Began with M, didn't it? They drove brilliantly.
Mystic.
Mystic, that's it. Fantastic races.
They drove like a sir.
They didn't, and I found it funny that both me and Mike were like, how the hell have you done that? So well done, guys. Top driving.
Yeah, as soon as Mystic got past me, I was like, I tried to keep up with him. I was like, right, I can keep up with him here. And then it came to like turning, I think it was into the first Lesmo. And of course, not being used not having had.
Who's going to heal Chuggy?
Running behind a person, like a second behind someone, I just went straight on. Freeze, motherfucker.
Well, anyway, I think that pretty much wraps up all that. I think Bahrain is the really pressing concern that we need to talk about. But I think that's our two cents collectively. I mean, guys, obviously, I'm of one opinion. You've got different, say it.
And. Bloody hell, Chuggy.
Sorry, I heard the click.
You almost touched me. What do you think about my animation? Chuggy, Matt, I haven't seen it because, you know, this is before I've
uploaded. I have seen it.
Oh, Matt's seen it, yes. But Chuggy, you haven't. But what do you guys think of my animation I did for uni? It took me, well, I started making it January this year. Finished it a week ago.
Fuck me, that was
two ago. What do you guys think? Because, you know, big project.
Crap! Not you, Tom. I'm just about to get raped.
I'm so depressed.
Well, anyway, guys, I think that wraps that up. Thank you guys for participating in those community races. But for now...
For now?
It's going to be a different version of PTFO. And it's
damn you, sir! I've just got this painted! No, gravel! But, yes... For now, community races, no more. We'll try and find something else to do.
When are you thinking of doing that? No, I'll raise that later.
Oops.
Damn you.
Sir. Well, until next time, guys.
Don't forget to rate, subscribe, hate, criticize, all that. Spam Matt's YouTube account.
Remember, all floppy, the good things.
Flippy floppy fail.
Why are you gonna spam me up, yo?
Why not?
What's this?
Oh, you want a game?
Bada the Whoopi!
That's racist.
Burnout, where we did the, what's it called? The tug of war. Just two cars pushing each other on that construction site.
That was a long time ago.
Yeah.
Oh, that was good.
Love Burnout. Anyway, we're dragging this on a bit, aren't we?
We are a bit.
Take care, guys.
SDF, I
know it's bad news, but, you know, there's no other way we can put it, really. Anyway. Tara?
No good way to give bad news.
Chuggy, say goodbye. Matthew, say
goodbye. I've got a question for you, Tom. Right? Why don't you try and do a video which isn't about Formula One?
Oh, snap!
Bye.
Okay. I see where this is going.
And tune in on my channel on Wednesday for that one.
Well, you've seen it, haven't
you? What?
But, yeah.
Okay, fine.
The video recorded last night.
Yeah, that's good. Oh, that'd be good.
Anyway, comment, rate, subscribe. That Jim, thank you for watching. Thank you for hating. All that.
Thanks for hating. you're encouraging the trolls?
Why not?
Anyway, beat them!
Take care, guys.
Beat him, troll them.
Tara, say goodbye, lads.
Goodbye, lads.
Oh, fair play, Tricky.
Bye bye.